My name is Marcel Sweetering, and I'm professor of food microbiology at Wageningen University and member of the ICMSF since 2005. This presentation explains the anatomy of a sampling plan. Sampling is sometimes described in wording like absence of salmonella. This sounds great, but this is a very loose statement and not clearly defined. Much more information is needed to fully describe a sampling plan, and furthermore, different types of sampling plans exist. Presence-absence tests versus quantitative sampling plans, and two-class and three-class sampling plans. So let's look at some described sampling plans as defined in Codex Alimentarius. On this slide, you see a sampling plan for powdered infant formula, which includes information for Chronobacter and Salmonella. Notice that in this sampling plan description, you see much more than only absence of Chronobacter and Salmonella. By the way, the absence can be found in the column for C, which says C equals zero for both pathogens. In addition to this, the number of samples N is defined, as well as the sample weight and the analytical method used. All these aspects together define the plan. In the Codex Hygiene Code for powdered infant formula, hygiene criteria are also described for mesophiles and Enterobacteriaceae. For the Enterobacteriaceae, the test remains a qualitative test describing N, C, the sample weight, and the analytical method. But C now is equal to 2, allowing some samples to be positive. However, notice that for the mesophiles, the test is quantitative instead of presence-absence test in a certain sample weight. It even specifies two concentration limits. In this case, it is a three-class sampling plan with a lower limit small m and a higher limit big M. No samples of the five are allowed to be above the 5,000 per gram. Two samples are allowed to be between 500 and 5,000, and the others have to be below the 500. So now look at the anatomy of a sampling plan. For Chronobacter in powdered infant formula, the N equals 30, meaning that 30 samples are taken, the C equals 0, so none of the 30 samples are allowed to be above the microbiological limit, and the microbiological limit in this case is absence in 10 grams. All these values need to be defined. For Enterobacteriaceae, N equals 10 samples. 2 can be positive, and the microbiological limit is absence in 10 grams. For mesophiles, the number of samples is 5. 2 of the 5 samples can be between the limits small m and big M, and the small m and big M are microbiological limits that now are given in a quantitative way, so it's not presence-absence test, but counts. The last type of sampling plan described here is one that is not in the powdered infant formula criteria and that is a quantitative two-class sampling plan. That can be, for example, a plan for Listeria monocytogenes, as in the European legislation for products not supporting growth of Listeria. The number of samples equals 5 samples, and none of the samples can be positive, and the microbiological limit is quantitative and equals 100 colony-forming units per gram. So sampling plans come in several forms, and all aspects need to be specifically defined. On the one side there are qualitative and quantitative plans, and on the other side there are two-class and three-class sampling plans. Three-class sampling plans are always quantitative. So qualitative three-class plans do not exist, but the other three combinations do exist. Apart from the number of samples and the number of samples that are accepted to be positive, the method also needs to be defined, and the microbiological limit. The limit is defined as a concentration for quantitative test and absence in a defined analyzed sample weight for qualitative test. Further information can be found in Microorganisms in Food 8 of the ICMSF.